Well, so far, I have installed the steering rack on this car. This right here. If you notice, there's some little white foam washers right here at the end of the turnbuckle. They're basic little dust covers for the ball end, so that the dirt won't get in there and mess it up. Now, as I'm putting this back together, I'm gonna go in and put the turnbuckles back in the spec. The front turnbuckle is right here, supposed to be 1.8 inches or 45.9 millimeters. And right here, the steering turnbuckle, supposed to be 1.59 inches or 40.5 millimeters. Now, I have a micrometer right here, and I'm going to check that out real quick, let you see that I'm pretty much on point. If not, well, we'll just have to adjust it. Now, I don't know if you can see this, but that's 1.80 inches. And the way I check that is I take the turnbuckle and I put it right in the center of the turnbuckle cap, and I measure it, and if it's wrong, well, I move it out or in, and the same on the other side. Now, that's 1.8 on this one, so that means this one has to be opened up some more, and that one has to be opened up just a couple turns. Now, like I said, for the steering one, it's supposed to be 1.59. So I take my micrometer and I move it over to 1.59. And when I get 1.59, then I have an idea of how close I am to this. All right, that's 1.59. And as you can see, I'm way off on that one too. So what I'm gonna have to do is correct them. I'll do that now. As I'm putting this car back together, I'm gonna also make the adjustments to the car as I go along, so I'm going to have to come back later and do it. Right now, you see the front bumper is on, the lower suspension arms is on, the steering rack is back on. Now, what I'm going to do is take my droop gauge right here from Team Associated, and I'm going to adjust the droop. Now, for the front, it's supposed to sit on number 4. So what I'm going to do is put this under here like such, where number 4 is, and then see if it matches up, which it should. Well, actually, it does. It's sitting on number 4 on this, and then I do the same thing. Right there is number 4, and the arm is sitting perfectly. Now I'm gonna do the same thing to the other side. Take this off, flip it around. It's a great tool to have. Sit it on there, slide it over, and back enough that you could actually see it. number four, sitting perfectly. Now that's set. Now I can actually go on and assemble the upper suspension. Moving right along, I've installed the front bumper. The next part I want to do is the transmission case. I've clipped the transmission case up. I greased it up like it was supposed to be greased. Now I want to go on and install it back on the car. I'll slide it back in here. And that's that. I take and screw this top front bumper screw on here, which is right here. I'll screw that back on. That's going to hold it in place. Like such. Then I'm going to put the transmission case braces on. Like such. There's two screws that go on either side. I'm going to install them real quick. And then there's four screws that go on the bottom of this. Going to go on and put them on after I do that, and that'd be that. That's two. It's the third one. And the fourth one. Now I turn the car over, and you'll see there's four holes right here. They require the four screws that I have left. Once I do that, then that'll be the transmission case installed. And the actual shaft that goes to the car. That's about it. After I take and put this last screw on. Sorry about the picture. Put this last screw on. And we're done. There you have it. Next, I'm going to take the steering hub right here, connected to the suspension arm, and also to the out drive right here. Now, it tells you in the instructions manual to put a little bit of black grease onto the ends of the pivot ball, and then screw it into your suspension arm. Also, look at your hub. There's a lettering to tell you left and right. It'll be an L or an R on there. That lets you know if it's left or right side. This is the left side. What I'm going to do now is thread this pivot ball into the lower suspension arm right here. And get it pretty much where it's got to be. There's a tool right here that I'm going to use that's going to gauge me. I tighten that up as tight as it goes, and then I'll back off of it just a little bit. And that's supposed to be how you check to make sure that you got it right. And that's that. I take in, put this in here like that. That's done. I take this arm right here, and then I'll do the same thing with this. Screw it in there, and then that'll be the suspension completely done.